Human rights activists and medical nonprofits are calling on the Greek government to evacuate overcrowded refugee camps on islands in the Aegean Sea to prevent COVID-19 from causing a humanitarian disaster. They are particularly concerned about Moria camp on the island of Lesbos, which special correspondent Malcolm Brabant has visited many times over the past 5 years, and he is in touch with people there now. Malcolm?
Judy, tonight I'm reporting from home again. I'm in the middle of the English countryside. I've got space to breathe, and I want for nothing. But 2,000 miles away, in one of the toughest locations in Europe, living conditions in this age of the coronavirus couldn't be worse. They've fled wars, persecution, or economic hardship. But in Moria, they're stranded with no place to run and no place to hide from COVID-19.
Nobody cares about us. Nobody cares about us. We are waiting how to die. Sorry to tell you about that, but this is the truth.
Raid Alab is the unofficial leader of the Arabic-speaking refugees in Moria. It was originally intended as a transit camp for 3,000 people when the refugee crisis began in 2015. But the influx has never stopped, and the population in tents and hovels sprawling beyond the razor wire is about 20,000. The whole of Greece is on lockdown, and the authorities are making sure the people of Moria stay within what critics label an open prison. Raid lives outside the official camp. There's no running water for essential self-protection, as he told me via WhatsApp.
I should walk from this area around 500 meters to go to the bath, bring empty bottles, fill it with water, and bring it again from there to here, stopping at the line maybe 1 hour.
In February, we went inside Moria, where Afghans eke out a living making flat bread, and met 13-year-old Mahteb Moradi, who was scared about violence in the camp.
We need peace.
Now, she told me via WhatsApp, a different type of tension is rising.
The people are scared because when the coronavirus come here, nobody can save their life.
Lesbos has just registered its first virus-related death, an elderly Greek woman who was apparently infected by her daughter, a health worker. As a result, two medical centres have been closed. So far, COVID-19 has not reached Moria, but volunteer doctors there fear it's just a matter of time.
God forbid that we actually have an outbreak in the camp, because that would be a real disaster. That would be a humanitarian crisis on another level. We are really, I think, sitting on a time bomb.
Dr. Jamila Shirali works inside Moria with the Boat Refugee Foundation, a Dutch non-profit.
On the ground, we're doing all we can. But I am convinced that this is, despite our best efforts, I think this is a war that we are going to lose if COVID-19 actually breaks out in Moria.
If you were trying to create a human petri dish for virus and bacteria, Moria would be a good choice.
I'm here at this camp.
Bill Frelick of Human Rights Watch was in Lesbos earlier this month, monitoring conditions aboard a Greek Navy ship where several hundred people from Moria were placed before being transported to a camp on the mainland. Frelick has a proposition for the Greek authorities.
The main thing really is to decongest the camp. And one suggestion that I would have is you have a tourist industry in Greece that is suffering because you have empty hotels throughout the country. As an emergency measure, put some of these people into those places.
Today in Lesbos, municipal workers have been disinfecting streets as trepidation grows amongst the 86,000 Greeks on the island. Local councillor Vespina Gabriel doesn't believe the hotels should open.
We've actually closed our hotels. We're not allowing anybody in the island or off the island.
We met Vespina Gabriel in February when she and others barricaded access roads to the proposed site of a new refugee camp to stop building work. She believes the government's current lockdown is protecting all 100,000 on the island, Greeks and refugees alike.
As far as Moria, as long as they're staying in their campsite, they're okay. You know, they're not having interaction on the street. They're not having interaction with us. We're not having interaction with them.
But Dr. Jamila Shirali made this appeal to the European Union.
I think the only possible way in which an outbreak would not lead to a humanitarian disaster is if we get an evacuation of the people from Moria and a relocation of the refugees in other EU states.
But most of Europe is locked down, and it has ignored the plight of Lesbos for years. So Moria's residents have to hope that the fortitude that enabled them to escape conflict and other troubles will continue throughout the coronavirus crisis. For the PBS NewsHour, I'm Malcolm Brabant.